This video is brought to you by CatBeast.com. Design your own custom snapbacks and hats.
It was just that he was all alone, always by himself. Never anyone to share the game. A man who lived in dreams. That's who he was.
Whatever, I just wanted to compete now. Enough is enough. Let's get me back in the mix. It's a forgetful business, Ariel. You know that yourself. Sure, look, Nate was out of the game, and now he's back and he's on top. It's a crazy business we are in, but make no mistake, the skills are there for me, and I know what I can bring to the table and what I will bring to the table, and I'm very, very excited to give my fans something to cheer about again. You know what I mean? I do this for my fans, for the people that are supporting me, for the people that dare to dream the highest of heights, so I look forward to my triumphant return, Ariel. Stare at your past and you'll end up staying there. It's okay to look back and admire it, but you carry on. I'm not in the business of staring back at it. You know what I mean? And getting lost back there. People say a loss can make or break a fighter. But trust me, a win can also make or break a fighter, because they get comfortable with a win. People can get comfortable with a win. And slack off then. Slack off on the training. Slack off on the diet. They've won one. They're winners now. That's not me, you know. You sleep on a win and you'll wake up with a loss. So I just carry on.
I would like to announce the return of the notorious Conor McGregor will be on January 18th at the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, Nevada. So that's the date, and the opponent is going to be Donald Cowboy Cerrone.
Welcome back everybody to Keating KTV. Just announced by Brad Okamoto, Conor McGregor will return on January 18th against Donald Cowboy Cerrone. However, there is a catch. But before we get to the catch, this video has been sponsored by CapBeast.com. If you guys are interested in creating and designing your own custom hats, then be sure to check out CapBeast.com with the link in the description below. To add on top of the news, Conor McGregor will be fighting Cerrone at the 170-pound division. This will be his third fight in that weight class. Obviously, the last two fights came in against Nate Diaz. One he won, and another one he lost. So, in my opinion, going into this fight season, whatever Conor called it at the press conference, he said that he wanted to fight three times next year, starting with January, obviously. So, Donald Cerrone, he's a good opponent. In terms of, you know, name value, Donald has always been a fighter that would always be respected, right? There's not a fight that Donald goes into and is, you know, kind of swept under the rug. No, every fight that Donald has been in has always caught the attention of the true hardcore fans. Everybody always tuned in for Donald. So for Conor to pick Cerrone, who just, you know, obviously came off of two losses, one against Tony, one against Gaethje, the man's steam is not where it used to be. When he came from the welterweight division defeating Mike Perry, and then he came back and defeated Ally Quinta, that was precisely the moment Conor should have, like, went into the fight and beat him. Now going into a fight against somebody who lost to Tony and Gaethje, it feels like a sloppy second at this point. If there is no real steam behind Cerrone, then there is not really a lot of steam for Conor McGregor to go in there, win, and get all the credit for it. That steam is not going to be there. It's just going to be, like, not really what it would be if it happened when Donald was on his roll. However, better late than never. And obviously this fight will be taking place at the 170-pound division. You can say that before Donald left that division, he was looking pretty good, defeating Mike Perry with a pretty sick submission armbar. You can say that, okay, that is probably the division that Donald Cerrone, at this stage of his career, at this age, will probably feel a lot more comfortable at. Cutting down to lightweight, personally, I would say that it's not really the best thing for Cerrone. The only thing that it's not really good for is obviously his body, right? But in terms of competition, the people at 170 pounds, they're just a lot bigger than him. So he's always going to be really undersized. So giving up and enduring a pretty rough weight cut to make the lightweight limit is obviously going to be a lot more preferable if you're going to be going into fights and want to perform optimally and not get outsized and face up against a Darren Till, right? You don't really want that. However, for Conor McGregor to also go up in weight class and fight him and challenge Cowboy Cerrone at a division where Cowboy is a lot more naturally suited at. I wouldn't really say Conor is pretty naturally suited for the 170-pound division. I think that he's just about too small for that weight class in comparison with the other people in that weight class. Obviously, you know, we have people like Usman, we had Till, Stephen Thompson. These guys will seriously outsize Conor McGregor. Obviously, Jorge Masvidal is probably one of the other reasons why he wanted to go up a weight class and fight at that division. I was not really expecting Conor to come back to the 170-pound division. There literally was no reason for him to do that. Obviously, his opponent, Nate Diaz, was a fighter that would fill in only at the 170-pound division. For Donald Cerrone, that may have been something that he wanted to get out of there as well. You know, maybe he just didn't want to cut the weight and face somebody like Conor McGregor, right? You don't want to deplete your body. You don't want to be physically weak and drained from the weight cut and face a very powerful fighter, very powerful puncher like Conor McGregor. If you're going to do it, then at least do it right. And that's exactly what Donald Cerrone is doing right now. He's not taking any risks. He's just playing it safe. And he knows that Conor McGregor is pretty desperate for an opponent just like him. There's not really another opponent in the division that has the longevity, the Hall of Fame status. So it's pretty good that Donald Cerrone did this for himself. In my opinion, this could be not the best thing for him, for Conor McGregor, obviously. Weighing in against Nate Diaz 1 and Nate Diaz 2, I'm pretty certain Conor McGregor weighed in at 168 pounds. He didn't even make the weight limit. He was just underweight, essentially. He didn't even have to cut weight, essentially. So for him to go to that weight class, at first it would concern me, but obviously Cerrone is a fellow lightweight fighter as well. At least former, or what is it? Yeah, I mean former lightweight and welterweight, the in-betweener. He's been doing it both. For him to go in there and fight somebody like that, that's okay. Right, he's not going in there and fighting the biggest of welterweights out there. So in terms of that, I think Conor's going to be pretty fine. The fact that Conor is not going to be cutting weight is probably going to be playing in his favor as well. So both fighters are really going to be benefiting from this, right? So Conor going into the welterweight division, he's going to be pretty bulky. He's going to be pretty strong, right? As he was against Nate Diaz, as we saw, he was able to drop him 2-3 times. He looked pretty strong. My only concern with Conor is that he's probably not going to be going all 5 rounds. However, at the same time, we can't forget that this is Conor McGregor. Usually, if Conor is going to win, and I'm assuming that he is going to win this fight, it is most likely going to come in the first or second round, just the finish. For him to make this fight happen at 170, it is going to be playing in his favor in terms of power. I think he's going to be powerful, and Conor is already a pretty powerful fighter. When it comes to Cerrone, he's kind of known to be a pretty, I'd say, not really the toughest of fighters when it comes to taking big hits. Cerrone has been known to fall under the powerful punches. You know, RDA was able to fold him, Darren Till. And assuming that Conor McGregor is going to be able to land his significant strikes early on, I think that he probably could fold him as well. I highly doubt that we'll see something really spectacular. I think Conor's really going to get it done in a manner that is not going to be that impressive. I don't really think that he's going to be starching Cerrone, because at the 170-pound division, I highly doubt that, we're going to have a fragile Donald Cerrone. That was one of the reasons why Donald Cerrone moved up, because he was just too weakened by the weight cut. So for him to be very healthy and pretty motivated, that'll really play into this fight. And possibly, Cerrone may take this fight and then retire afterwards. Who really knows, right? So Conor, I'm happy he's back. But for the future, it really is concerning. If he's really planning on going in there and fighting Donald Cerrone, and then continue to fight for the BMF title against Jorge Masvidal, I think the Jorge Masvidal fight is going to be a very, very tough fight for him. It is, in my opinion, the toughest opponent that he's going to be facing in the stand-up department. Up until this point, we didn't really have an opponent that we could consider to beat Conor McGregor in the stand-up. Jorge is that individual, in my opinion. So, if Conor really wants to go in there and fight Khabib, right, that's really the only fight that we're all, thrilled to see, the rematch. If that is his end goal by next year, I don't really know if he is going to be getting it by fighting twice at welterweight. That does not really make any sense to me. If Conor is going to fight Cerrone and then Jorge Masvidal, let's assume he beats both of them. Is he going to get a title shot fighting Khabib? I don't really think so. So if he's going to go in there and fight both of these guys at welterweight, I'm suggesting you guys to not really depend on the Conor McGregor versus Khabib 2 rematch. Khabib maybe has 2 more fights in him, maybe 3 at most. And right now, at the lightweight division, we have Justin Gaethje, who's been looking pretty good. And then we have Tony Ferguson, who will be fighting Khabib in April or March or whatever it may be, right? So these two are the only two guys left, and one of them is already booked. So if he's going to come back after the Jorge Masvidal fight, if that even is going to happen, right? We're not really too sure. Maybe Conor's going to go there, fight Cerrone, then come back and wait, fight Gaethje. And then with that, I would say that he earned himself a title shot. Khabib said that, he wanted Conor to have 10 fights, but come on, that's going to be taking 5 years, obviously. Obviously, he said it as a joke, and even if he weren't taking it serious, it's not a realistic time frame, right? Obviously. So if Conor and Khabib is going to happen again, if that rematch is going to be happening, it should happen next year. It really should happen next year. The best case scenario, the best case scenario that Conor really can ask for to fight Khabib again, regardless of the belt, is for Tony Ferguson to defeat Khabib. If Tony Ferguson can defeat Khabib, I would say that Justin Gaethje would be next in line, so Justin can fight him. And then by that point, maybe Conor can go in there and fight Khabib for an interim belt, right? Then we can have the best of both worlds. Conor versus Khabib 2 for a belt, you know, it's like the first time. But that is assuming Khabib will lose, which I highly doubt he will. So if it really were to come down to a rematch, next year, 2020, maybe December, maybe October, November, whatever it may be, right? I think that is a time frame for that to happen. As for Conor McGregor's future, this is the first step, right? This is the very important step. Actually get a fight happening. And that is really what we all wanted. I'm not too sure why it took so long, but I'm glad it is here. I think that Conor McGregor is going to be a man on a mission. He's a fighter that, in my opinion, respects Donald Cerrone, but make no mistake about it, the respect that he has for Cowboy is not really going to be getting in his way of him really going to go into that fight with really bad intentions and finishing the opponent. So in my opinion, Conor is going to go in there full Conor mode. Really, he's going to be going in there trying to prove a point, and I think that is a pretty dangerous Conor McGregor. A Conor McGregor that has a point to prove is, in my opinion, the best Conor McGregor that we could have wished for. So, with that being said, this is the return of the notorious Conor McGregor, January 18th, against Donald Cerrone at welterweight. Leave in the comment section down below what you guys think of this fight, and who do you guys think will win. As always, in the end, only time will tell what will truly happen. For now, I have been Keenan from Keenan KTV, signing off. Later.